The trade deadline ended today, and I'm going to show you that in NBA 2K21. ¿Qué pasa to the pack? It is Pack here.
AKA your mama's best friend.
Expect a very little amount of editing in this video. I don't have a lot of time. It is a lot to get through, so I'm just going to kind of give you the information. I'm not going to go through the trades. I'm literally just going to show you every team and their new players and the players they lost one by one, okay? If I don't mention your team, that's because they had basically no moves or trades or anything like that, okay? So we're going to start off with the Philadelphia 76ers. Now they get George Hill, 78 overall, making him the fifth best player on the 76ers. Whether or not he'll start off the bench, we'll have to wait and see. There's a lot of things they can do here, but he's a defender who can shoot. And you know what, man? I don't think the 76ers are like sad about that. That's a good move. They also get Knicks player Iggy Brazdeikis at the very back, 70 overall, their worst player, but a young talent who could, who knows, maybe be good in a couple years. This is one of the huge teams that got really different. Nikola Vucevic on the Bulls is now the second best player on this team. Zach LaVine gets a number two option, and this is a big deal. The Bulls are definitely in a playoff position, and they're going to get a lot better throughout the year now that they have Nikola freaking Vucevic with Lauri Markkanen still on the team, Thaddeus Young, Kobe White, and they also pick up Al-Farouq Aminu, who's a great player off the bench that can play some really good defense. So this is a huge, huge pickup for this team. They also get Daniel freaking Tice off the bench as well, which is huge. And on top of that, you're going to get Troy Brown Jr., who might get some minutes. A lot of changes for this team. The projected starting lineup is Kobe White, Zach LaVine, Patrick Williams, who's been great, Thaddeus Young, and Nikola Vucevic. But realistically, that's going to be the case. But yeah, I mean, still, this team went from a maybe playoff team to a guaranteed like sixth seed, maybe. Oh, wait, for the Cavs, the only player that ended up getting is Isaiah Hartenstein, who had some good games here and there with the Rockets, and I believe also he played for the Nuggets this season. Now they get him, and he could, you know, be helpful. I'm surprised no trade for Andre Drummond, but I guess they just couldn't figure something out. All right, the Celtics get a huge one. Evan Fournier, 82 overall on this team. Gonna kind of play the role that Gordon Hayward played last season, just get some buckets off, either off the bench or start, I'm assuming off the bench. You know what, dude, that's great for them. They needed something, man, because they were losing games. And this is a 20-point per game scorer right here every season, so, or at least lately. So I don't think the Celtics are upset that they got Evan Fournier, right? They also get a really good player from the Wizards, Mo Wagner. Dude, he's actually really solid as a center, and another pickup for this team that actually contribute offensively. Kind of a big one for the Clippers. They get Rajon Rondo, and they traded away freaking Lou Williams, but they get the point guard they wanted. This is a perimeter defender. He play makes well. He can get others open. And on top of that, he can actually hit threes because Rondo hits threes now. And you know Rondo steps up in the playoffs. This is exactly the starting point guard they needed. I know it says 75 overall, but Rondo on this team is going to go up. Guaranteed. Guaranteed. Okay, the Hawks get Lou Will back on the Hawks. I mean, you have five players in the 80 overall club, and that's just your starting lineup. Daniil Gallinari could go up too because how he's been playing lately. The Hawks are back in a playoff position, winning games now. And Lou Williams just adds even more fuel to that fire. This is a really, really good pickup for this team. Only getting better. The Miami Heat, they get some steals, just straight up. Okay, Victor Oladipo is now on the Miami Heat, making him the third best player, basically for free. They still got to keep Tyler Hero, Goran Dragic, and freaking Duncan Robinson throughout all this. And they somehow get Nemanja Bjelica. Bro, what? They also get him? Like, this is huge for this team. Great pickup. For the Jazz, kind of a small, not a big move, but they get Matt Thomas. Where is he? All the way over here. 73 overall, Matt Thomas for the Jazz, and that's literally it. The Kings get DeLon Wright, 77 overall. Not a bad player at all. They also get Terrence Davis from the freaking Raptors and Mo Harkless, and that's really it. Just a couple moves here and there. Oh, and Chris Silva. So they got a couple pieces here and there. A lot of young guys. I mean, they're not rebuilding, but they're kind of just trying to retool and see if they can get better next season, but that's really it. The Knicks get Terrence Ferguson, who's one of their worst players now, but they got rid of Austin Rivers, and I guess that's it. I don't expect Terrence Ferguson to get a lot of minutes, just straight up. Okay, so for the Magic, now it's Wendell Carter Jr. as their best player with Otto Porter. Super weird. This is a hardcore rebuild for this team. They also get Gary Harris and RJ Hampton, so a couple moves here to rebuild, but just a complete blow up of the team, man. A complete blow up. It's crazy. But yeah, this is definitely now, talent-wise, one of the worst teams in the NBA as of today. The Mavericks, now you have to get some pretty important pickups for the team. So they get JJ Redick. So now you get JJ Redick can actually play on a team because the Pelicans were not using him. They also get Nicola Melli, who, you know, could get some minutes too. Who knows? They need as much firepower off the bench as they can get. So they'll take it. The Nuggets get a huge pickup in Aaron Gordon. They have four players in the 80 overall club, and this is a team that's always trying to fight for the championship every year, and picking up Aaron Gordon as a starter is a huge deal. It's massive. They also, which is also a pretty good pickup, JaVale McGee off the bench, another pickup. I mean, hey, JaVale McGee's pretty good champion defender. Hey, not bad. Okay, so the Pelicans get Mavericks player Wesley Awundu, who plays defense and can shoot, and that's really it. Younger player, he could show up maybe for the Pelicans, who knows. The Pistons do get somebody. We have to get to talk about the Pistons this video. Is Corey Joseph now on the Pistons, and that's literally it. Where is he? There he is. Corey Joseph, 71 overall, now on the Pistons, and that's literally all they got out of this. But hey, I mean, they're in rebuild mode, so it doesn't really matter for them. Okay, so for the Raptors, first of all, we have Gary Trent Jr. now on the Raptors, 78 overall, only 21 years old, so it's actually not a bad pickup for the Raptors at all. I mean, they do lose Norman Powell, but they low-key just didn't want him, and they're kind of rebuilding too, kind of. They're like retooling. They're kind of a weird team. I don't know why they're not winning, to be honest. They also get Rodney Hood, because why not? 73 overall. I mean, he might get minutes, he might not. I'm not really sure. So the Spurs. The Spurs end up getting Marquese Chriss, 76 overall. He would be the backup center on this team, especially because LaMarcus Aldridge was bought out, so he's not on the team anymore. Hey, you know what, though, Spurs? I'm okay with this. First of all, he's injured, so he probably won't play, but he's a good rebounder. He can defend in the paint and can score in the paint, so kind of just a worse hurdle. Okay, so he gets a couple players, which, you know, some options. Tony Bradley, 75 overall, 22 years old, now on the team. Young player is what they want. Austin Rivers, a glue guy who can hustle, play defense, and shoot threes on the OKC as well. I mean, why not? Good pickups for them. So a pretty big one, Norman Powell, third best player on the Blazers. Now, this is a 20-point per game scorer now on the Blazers. You got another bucket getter, which is huge for this team. It sucks that they don't have Nurkic because he's injured again, but it's just, you're doing what you can. You want to go for the championship. You're going to try at least, and getting Norman Powell was definitely the move to do. And finally, the Wizards got a couple moves. Daniel Gafford is now on the team as a starting center, probably because they're going to need somebody to play defense on this team, and that's why they got Daniel Gafford. And then they also get Chandler Hutchinson, who's only 24 years old, 75 overall. A little bit of help off the bench. They need all of it they can get. And these are all the moves. Who do you think has the biggest W this trade deadline? I think it's the Heat. Let me know in the comments below. And if you like this channel, give it a sub. And I'll see you guys next time.